The Kennedy Class I arch form is defined as an arch having bilateral edentulous spaces posterior to the remaining natural teeth. The purpose of this video is to propose a design for a clasp-retained removable partial denture to restore this Kennedy Class I arch form. We will list some of the simulated findings and give a rationale for the components selected. The patient exhibits deep vertical overlap of the anterior teeth. The patient has a loss of posterior support with a reduced vertical dimension of occlusion. Inadequate space exists for the placement of the partial denture. We will attempt the restoration of the patient's vertical dimension to obtain space for the framework and teeth. We check the patient's closest speaking space by asking the patient to repeat the word Mississippi and to observe the amount of space between the anterior teeth. We may also make an occlusal therapy appliance using acrylic to restore the patient to the correct vertical dimension. This allows one to test the patient's ability to tolerate a change in vertical dimension as well as their ability to adapt to a removable prosthesis. We observe that the remaining teeth are in excellent periodontal health. This implies that there is no abnormal mobility requiring splinting, and we do not anticipate any tooth loss due to periodontal disease. Periodontal surgery, which could affect the aesthetic result, is not required. The patient is not aesthetic conscious. This is a favorable result, implying that the patient will not object to showing a metal clasp. No buccal bone or soft tissue undercuts are present. Undercuts of this nature may preclude the use of a preferred clasp, prevent intimate contact of the base with the supporting tissue, or dictate altering the path of insertion of the partial denture. Occasionally, surgery would be required in some cases to eliminate these undercuts. No decay or restorations are present. Any existing restorations must be carefully considered for their impact on the prognosis of the removable partial denture. For example, would failure of an existing restoration compromise the success of the partial denture, and how difficult would it be to replace? Ideally, all decay should be treated prior to making the partial denture. Also included in the examination is to identify the vibrating line. This landmark is noted by the blue line and represents the junction between the movable and immovable tissue of the palate. It normally will run from hamular notch to hamular notch and may often be estimated to be 2 millimeters anterior to the fovea palatini. We will make and survey diagnostic casts mounted on the articulator in the retruded position. By surveying the cast, we will determine the adjustments to be made to establish guiding planes, axial recontouring, rest seat placement, and areas of retention. Also, we will examine the cast for potential dark triangles, areas of aesthetic concern, as well as interferences to the path of insertion. Initially, the path of insertion will be established with short guiding planes formed on the distal of the canines, and vertical support for the partial denture will rely on canine rest seats and support from the hard palate. Several options are available for rest seats for the maxillary canine, but in this case we will utilize mesial ball rests. The ball rest will likely be easily accessible from the adjacent embrasure space in cases where minimal vertical space exists. The fulcrum line is thus established. The fulcrum line is normally present in all Kennedy Class I and II partial denture designs and should be identified. Next, we select the complete palatal plate major connector. The complete palatal plate is normally used when abutment support is minimal. This rigid major connector will maximize vertical support, and intimate adaptation of the partial denture with the underlying tissue will assist with retention of the partial denture. Base selection options consist of the metal base with bead retention or ladder retained acrylic. Beaded metal is superior with respect to strength, cleansability, and adaptation to the tissue, and is especially useful in areas of limited space, Disadvantages are that it cannot be relined or adjusted. Acrylic bases may be relined and are simple to adjust. They may be retained by ladder or mesh. About 1.5 millimeter exists beneath the ladder for the acrylic base. This ladder always is supported by a tissue stop, which supports the framework during try-in and processing. Internal and external finish lines are present in areas where acrylic joins the metal framework. The location of the finish line should be placed carefully to allow correct palatal contours to be formed. With distal retention, the modified T retainer is selected. Clasping is more efficient when placed adjacent to the edentulous space, and in conjunction with the lingual plate, the modified T may assist the indirect retainer when the partial denture rotates occlusally under the influence of gravity and sticky foods. Preparation of the mouth is verified by examining the master cast with the surveyor. The cast is then tripodded, and the master cast, laboratory prescription, and sketch are sent to the dental laboratory for framework construction. When the framework is returned, examine it for rocking, abrasions on the cast, and ensure the prescription has been followed, and that the retentive elements are appropriately located. Upon verifying seating of the framework in the patient, a light-cured record base is constructed with a wax occlusion rim at the correct vertical. A jaw relation record at the retruded position is made, and artificial teeth are selected for shade and form. The denture is tried in the mouth, and the occlusion is evaluated. There should be bilateral simultaneous contact of the posterior teeth in the retruded position, with freedom of movement in excursions. Lateral contacts, if any, should be as far anterior as possible. This animation is intended to illustrate the action of the modified T direct retainer to occlusal loading. Assuming it engages the tooth distal to the fulcrum line, the clasp tip should disengage from the undercut. When the partial denture rotates towards the occlusal plane in response to sticky foods or gravity, the modified T will engage the undercut and, in conjunction with the lingual plate, provide a degree of indirect retention. In this video, we have described the use of a clasp-retained removable partial denture designed to restore the Kennedy Class I arch according to some simulated criteria. The rationale for each component was given, and a brief exposure to the occlusal scheme for restoring a vertical dimension was given. Thank you.